no, I haven't. He says, well, it turns out that too much CBD can actually affect the same receptors in the liver that Tylenol hits, acetaminophen, and can actually poison the liver. And it was discovered because some very heavy CBD users noticed their urine was turning dark, like they had hepatitis. And it got the name black urine disease. And he tells me, and I haven't talked to the FDA about this, that the FDA is worried that big time CBD use, and I don't know the dose, may potentially damage the liver, and that's why they put the brakes on this. But look it up, it's fascinating.
Yeah, you know, I have seen some things talking about CBD damaging the liver because of studies that they did in mice or rats. Right. And from what I could gather from these studies, the amount of CBD they had to give these rats was huge, like thousands and thousands and thousands of milligrams of CBD, like what it would equal with a human. It seemed very, very like a huge stretch to me, but I will look that up and see what they're saying about black urine disease, because that sounds pretty scary.
And you probably couldn't afford to take that much.
Right, exactly.
So let's get back to that. Is there evidence, is there at least anecdotal reports about the amount of CBD that you have to use to be effective? You mentioned that everybody's endocannabinoid system is different. So what should people look for? What do they try? What do you recommend?
Yeah, as far as dosing, I mean, I've heard from doctors that practice with cannabis medicine that some patients do well on 5 milligrams of CBD and some people do well on 500 milligrams of CBD, depending on their condition. So it's really, really different. But what I can say is a starting point for CBD, you want to start really low and take it by itself and monitor how you feel, you know, every 15 minutes. Like, do you feel anything different? Do you feel you're more relaxed? Do you feel any relief of pain? Do you feel any relief of anxiety or whatever it is that you're trying to find relief from? And pay really close attention and only take more if you feel nothing. If you feel nothing, take a little bit more. But you could start with like 5 milligrams, even something really small, and see if you feel anything. If not, you know, around 15 to 25 milligrams is a standard dose for people, for many people. A standard kind of wellness dose. And then if you're having a high amount of pain or anxiety, you may need to take a little bit more and just kind of move up until you find the relief that you're looking for, or switch products if it's not working for you, or methods of delivery. They're, like you said before, you know, topicals work really well for some people, for pain. For anxiety, a lot of people like to take the tincture under the tongue because that works usually within 15 minutes or so, and you can really measure your dose drop by drop. So I would suggest starting with a sublingual tincture, because that's how you can really, really get a measured dose and say, okay, I took this exact amount, where some of the other methods, you can't always know exactly how much you're taking.
Okay, so we talked about anxiety, pain, sleep, and you used the buzzword, the wellness dose of CBD. So again, help me experimentally, anecdotally, where does CBD fit in a wellness regimen?
Sure. Well, like I said before, we all have this endocannabinoid system in our body that CBD works directly with, and we have our own molecules inside our body that work with this same system that CBD can help to regulate those molecules, and they affect things like, you know, pain, sleep, the immune system, anxiety, depression, mood. They have so many things that this endocannabinoid system affects. It really keeps you in homeostasis or keeps you in balance. So taking CBD as a daily tonic is kind of, you know, tonifies your endocannabinoid system and can keep things in balance. Many people just find that taking it, you know, as a daily thing, whether it's at night or during the day, depending how you respond, can just make you overall, you know, feel more balanced.
Gotcha. Okay. Interesting. Dr. McCollin and I have talked about CBD